kids from the building even without grabbing their own personal effects, phones and things of that nature. When the fire department arrived, they were in the process of coming down the stairs as we were going into the building. We found heavy fire conditions in the rear of the building already. We began our operations, and our primary concern, of course, was life safety. We did a complete search of the building and ensured that there was nobody left behind or no other occupants in the building. We began attacking the fire, but the fire rapidly moved through the four floors of the building as well as the basement. And due to the safety hazards to our people, we were forced to pull out of the building approximately 30 minutes after the fire began. We called on many other agencies. Dunkirk Police Department and Public Works Department were involved right from the start, as well as WCA Services. We called for help from 15 fire departments in Chautauqua County. They sent us approximately 25 pieces of equipment, including three aerial devices. Approximately 100 to 150 firefighters were involved at the height of the incident. We were using approximately 7,000 gallons of water. We were able to accomplish two pump relays to Lake Erie and use water out of Lake Erie. At the height of the fire, we had the fire building as a complete loss early on in the incident. We were attempting to protect the adjoining buildings on either side. The social services building was extensively damaged. The North County office building received water and smoke damage, but after a walkthrough yesterday with the structural engineer, it was determined that structural damage and actually there was no fire damage. The structural damage was, the building is very sound.
So there is a letter circulating. I don't know if we received a copy of that yet at the city level, but we did receive a letter from the structural engineer concurring that the Grant building was indeed reusable.
Right, so we're really happy, the fire department were really happy with that result. We're most happy with the fact that there were no casualties. We did have one firefighter with a minor injury, but with the occupancy of the building, it's really remarkable that this isn't a much worse tragedy. Obviously, all the businesses have been permanently displaced from 323 Central, and as well as temporarily from your facility, the North County building. And we really don't know about the social services building, about its viability right now. Just want to backtrack a little bit. At the height of the incident, I was in command of most of the incident. I felt that not only adjoining buildings were in jeopardy, but also the buildings on the other side of Central Avenue. And we can see the architecture in the neighborhood to our west. The winds were light, but pushing the flames and embers somewhat to the southwest. The churches and wood structures in the neighborhood in the second ward were endangered. And it's really miraculous that with the help of the 15 other fire departments, the amount of water that we were able to bring to bear on the fire, that we were able to hold the damage to is, you know, as severe as it is, you know, a fire of that magnitude can be much worse, and we're happy that we were able to hold the damage to